What's up guys, SP Architects here. Today I'm going to show you how to create twisted or spiral building or a ramp building in ARCHICAD. When it comes to creating flat surface or flat buildings, you can use slab tool or simply you can use all of the tools here. But when it comes to creating a slope slab or curved at the same time, you need to follow different options, but luckily ARCHICAD can handle this building and this problem very easily. Actually, I prepared similar tutorials about this. If you haven't seen them, this tutorial is for you. You can start from this one. Each tutorial I follow another way, and each tutorial you will learn different ways of doing something in this channel. Alright, before we get started, I would just like to ask you to like this tutorial. It's going to help this channel with YouTube algorithms. With your help, this channel will grow up. Do not forget to subscribe, of course. Alright, let's start the tutorial. At the beginning, I start with creating a simple circle, and its radius will be 300 centimeters. Now we create another circle. Its distance will be 700 meters. Now, as you can guess, it's 400 centimeters thickness. This is going to be a ramp. Maybe it's gonna start from here. And we have a thickness. It's gonna start from here or start from here and from this direction. So we're going to close this ramp building here with the help of the trim. We can trim. Okay, this is 2D, but we need 3D. In order to do that, other tutorials I followed the way with the mesh tool, but this time I am going to use slab tool. Let's click that with the space bar and fill inside. In the 3D window, we have this model. The thickness is 30 centimeters. All right, let's copy that. And we right click and we click convert selection to morph. Let's click OK. Now this is a morph. The building start from zero, finishes at 3 meters. So we will elevate some points over there, but we cannot directly elevate. We need to separate this object. For instance, here we can separate it with the help of the split tool. This one. Okay. And this is going to be flat. This is going to be a ramp. So I'm going to split this with two parts, but from the center. So our starting position is wrong. I'm going to delete them. Click the line and create a line here. After that, a slab here, a slab here. Now we can right click and convert selection to morph in the center. Now we can split from the right middle of the curve. Once we have this, we are going to hit Ctrl plus Shift and make a box selection to select this edge, and we hit Ctrl plus 9. Now it's going to be 150. With the same method, now this is going to be 300. And this slab will be on first story. There you go. Now we can copy this slab to here and rotate. Now this looks interesting. Now we can model our roofs for the building. Therefore, we go to story 1, right click ground floor, show as trace reference. By the way, the home story for the slab will be ground. This part will be roof, so with the help of the slab, we can place a slab here, another one here. And a ramp will be rise from this direction again. The easiest way doing that, of course, we can copy the previous one. And also this slab too, to story. This part is done. Now we can build our walls. Let's go to ground floor again. Go to wall tool, change the structure type to simple. You can change the thickness. Let's start modeling with this corner. From this corner, click the tangent and make a curve like this. Also in the inner part too. Let's change the direction with this icon. If we click the curve, you can see it's not following the perfect circle. We can fix that. Or for now, let's leave it as is. I'm going to change the starting to minus 20, minus 30. After that, we can just change height of the wall. And with the solid element operation, this is going to be a target and this is going to be operator. Subsection with a force extrusion, click execute. If you have something like this, you can change the offset value of the wall or you can change the slab edges. I'm gonna offset the wall maybe 3 centimeters, minus 3 centimeters, minus 5. There we go. Or a more value, minus 8. Just like that. Alright, base part of the building is done. Now we can start the modeling side windows. If you want to make it simple, you can just place walls around the building and change its material to glass. If you want to create complex model, you can always use curtain wall. For the tutorial, we will take curtain wall. Let's change direction, or let's just pick up another curtain wall settings. Alright, I have placed another curtain wall from my other tutorial. We can use this one. Let's just alt click and control alt click and paste its settings. Now I'm gonna change some settings inside from inside of this new one. I'm going to delete this center parts, center moldings from here. We just click roll box here and click minus. After that, we change the height. something like this. The width is okay. It's going to be a curl model, so the smaller value, the better model will be. Now, let's click OK. Maybe we can change direction. I'm going to make the boundary frames outside boundary and give it an offset value, something like this. Inside boundary will be get the trick. We are in the ground floor and continue modeling the windows. If you want to make circular window, you can use this curved one, but first I'm going to make something different. I'm going to create a simple straight and turn that into a curve, just like this. Let's do it once more. I think we can give that an offset. Minus maybe. There you go. Once we have this, we can change their height. How we can achieve that? First, we create the curtain wall and change their height, just like this. But for this one, we are going to click edit. Let's just right click the scheme grid. And we will see borders. If we click that, it turns to blue. With the help of the blue, we can change the site. It's very easy. Also for the inner one. This one will be start from here. And this point will be end from this point. If you want to add more points, you can click the edge and click insert new node, just like that. This is going to be a straight one, the easiest one. We can take a symmetry from the mid, from the center. A simple wall will be here. Okay, we can close the building here and we can place some doors. This is nearly done. If you want to create railings to turn this terrace to a balcony, we can always create the railing. And make some railing in the settings. We can create a favorite. I don't know, maybe this frame, this glass railing will do the trick. Just like that. There you go. This is how you can create twisted spiral ramp building in ARCHICAD. I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial. If so, please hit the like do not forget to subscribe. If you want to download this project file, you can find this project file in my Patreon page. In my Patreon page, you can reach my other files too. If you have any questions or suggestions, please comment in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.